Hello everyone, in this video I am going to tell about Docker Hub. The agenda of this video is to what is Docker Hub, what is Docker image, how to download Docker Hub image from Docker image from Docker Hub, customizing Docker image. Here I am using web server. You can use as per your case like Jenkins, Maven, Prometheus, etc., SQL, and pushing this image to the Docker Hub. Okay, so let's begin. Just open your browser and go to the Docker Hub. Docker Hub, what is Docker Hub? Docker Hub is the central repository where you can get the Docker image for any operating system or any operating system plus their dependency too, like web server operating system plus web server operating system plus database operating system plus monitoring servers. So in go to this explore, in the search box type CentOS, like CentOS. Okay, this is the official version of CentOS. If you click on this, this is the command to download this Docker image of CentOS. You can see the different versions of CentOS like 7, 8, 8.1, 7.1, 6, 6.6. So, and also you can see the different other things for the CentOS also. So CentOS with MariaDB, CentOS with MySQL, CentOS with PostgreSQL, CentOS with PHP. Okay, so at first download this raw image of CentOS provided by the official sources. So just to download this, copy this command. Okay, so if requirement is just you have the installed Docker Hub, anyone can download installed Docker in your system. Anyone can download the Docker image. So type whatever you have, just paste it. If you fire this command, it will download the latest version of CentOS. So if you colon and give the 7, it will download the CentOS 7. If you colon and 6, it will download the 6. So I am specifying the version 8. So it's going to download. It might take some time pulling from library. So downloaded newer image from CentOS 8. So you can see it's the fastest way. You can check it by Docker images command. Okay, you can see the CentOS 8 image has come. It's created 4 months ago by someone from the CentOS officials. So I can use this CentOS image to launch my operating system. Okay, just if you want to try, run this command, Docker run IT means interactive terminal. Okay, if you want to give the name of the operating system, I am giving the CentOS 8. Okay, and specify the what image you want to use. So I am using image CentOS, and this version, specify the version CentOS 8. It's creating the container. So using this image you can create the container of the Docker of the CentOS. Okay, it might take some time. can see it's created the container. Now you are inside the container cell. Okay, if you have any command, you can check it. If you want to check the user, you can check it. Who am I? You are the root. Okay, so you can do whatever you want inside the CentOS. So if you want to just know the IP of this containerized operating system, so fire IP config. Okay, command not found. Command not found. It's because it's the raw image of CentOS. So all the tools that gives that command are not available. If you want to download the tools, that is yum install. The name of the tool is net tools. Now you can see it's downloading. Okay, it's downloading. Just let it download. Now you can see the IP of new operating system that is created inside the Docker, and this operating system is of CentOS. It's downloading. This is downloading. So meanwhile, we can check the IP of our base operating system. So I am just launching one more terminal, and you can check the IP of this base operating system. Ifconfig. Okay. Now you can see the IP of this base operating system is this is 192.168.0.103. okay, so back to the this. So it has downloaded the net tools for us. So if I fire the if command, it will give the IP if config. Command not found. Operation. Is this okay? Yes, operating. Okay, since I have not said it yes or no, so it's not downloaded. Let it. Do yes. Again, yes. It's downloading. Now it's downloading. If you fire the ifconfig command, it will show the IP. So now the operating system launched by Docker, the IP of this operating system is 172.17.0.2. So if you want to ping your base operating system, if you just want to check the connectivity between the base operating system and container image and Docker operating system, means operating system running inside Docker, so ping 192. What's the IP is 192.168. This one, just copy and paste it. Okay, paste. You can see there is connectivity, good connectivity between the these two operating systems. This is 192.168.0.103 is the base operating system, that is Ubuntu, you can see. And you are seeing the if command, if config. It's the IP of running operating system. If you want to check how many processes are running, so the operating system are launched. So just do these things. pause the video because of this password. Okay, so if you want to check your operating system is running or not, you can fire this command docker ps. It is the processes for the docker. You can see this is container ID, this is image you have used, and this is the name of operating system you have given. Okay, so it's working fine. Now I want to install go to the shell of container. Now I want to install the Apache web server. Okay, so just do one thing. Yum command for installing is yum install httpd. Okay, it's installing. Say yes. It's downloading the packages. It may that depends upon the time. Okay, it has downloaded the Apache web server. Okay, now if you want to start this Apache web server, just do one thing. For this okay, you can see the operating system means process is running, that is operating system is running. If you want if config, you can still see the IP address. This is IP address of base operating system, and if config, and this is IP address of CentOS operating system running on Docker. So if you want to ping 192.168.103, you can clearly see the ping, as well as if you want to see the ping from base operating system, you can see ping 172.17.2. You can see it's pinging. So bidirectionally, it's pinging from and to the container. Okay. So I'm clicking this. Okay. Now, web server has been started. So for any web server, the first step is to install it. Second, start the web server. So for starting web server, we have used systemctl start httpd. Okay, system has not been booted with systemd as init system, so there are some problems with the systemctl command in Docker. So I have a hack. So I'm using this command. Okay, I'm using user sbin httpd. I'm using this command because internally systemctl uses this command, a user sbin httpd, to start the http service. So this is just the warning. Could not reliably determine the service fully qualified domain name. This set the service name. Okay. If you want it's working or not, just can see the port 80 is occupied, so it's working, means HTTP service has been started. So now just for testing I am creating a simple site. So you know, for every web server, for a web server the file should be located at this location, where www.html. To use this service, your files should be in this folder only. So I am creating a file, html. Okay. Just creating using vi. So this is my HTML is okay. You can see the content. This is my HTML page. Okay. Now if I want to access this page, I can access it. Since the Docker operating system, the container inside the Docker and the base operating system both are bi-directionally pingable, so I can access this site from my base operating system too, or from here too. I am using curl command and IP of the system 172.17.0.2 index.html. okay. So you can access this now. I am using my base operating system. Okay. So from here you can also access the site now. So in this way the site has been accessed from both the Docker and the base operating system too. Okay. Now we'll try to install or check whether PHP is working or not. I'm just checking it. Okay, to check whether PHP is working or not, or installed or not, just check by this. PHP is not found. Okay, so we need to install the PHP. Okay, it's installing. Yes. I'm just pausing because it may take sometimes. Okay, yeah, it's downloaded. Now PHP is complete. So I can check now. The PHP has been the PHP script is running. And it's working. So now I don't want to install these things, net tools and all these web servers and PHP again and again. So I am creating the image which consists of CentOS 8, and on the top of it net tools, PHP, web server and other things if you want to install. So I just want to clone this operating system image, Docker image, to another package. So for this I'm just getting out of this HTML folder. For this you just need to use the commit command. Okay, so using Docker commit you can do this. Okay, to do this go to the root of the base OS, that is this one. Okay, and fire the command Docker images, check the which images are there. Okay, and Docker PS to check which operating systems are running. Okay, so to clone this entire OS setup, Docker commit parent OS, that is the parent OS from where you want to clone it. So name of the parent OS is CentOS 8. Name of the OS, child OS will be clone OS will be, I am writing the name as Vikash web server CentOS 8 underscore Apache HTTPD is net tools then Apache HTTPD HTTPD and PHP. Okay, now it will clone. It's cloning, it might take some time. Oh yeah, it's cloned the image. So you can check this image by firing the command Docker images. So the image has been created here, you can check it. Okay, 11 second ago, 311 MB. Now you can check the size of base OS is 237 MB. The size of base OS is 237 MB and the new child image is 311 MB. That consists of base image plus net tools plus HTTPD plus PHP. Okay, now I need to upload it to Docker Hub. Okay, from where everyone can access, or you can access from wherever you want. Okay, to do this you need to do one thing.